Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for joining us on Stormwatch 9 Weather on the Web. And there is quite a storm that we are tracking. Details goes as such. A flood watch in effect for tomorrow morning into early Saturday morning because of a potential for 1 to 2 inches of rain leading to only minor issues. So I'll back out here, show you the timeline on this watch. Again, it begins early Friday morning, goes into early Saturday morning for minor issues. Why? The rainfall tallies will generally come in between 1 inch and 2 inches. That should prevent any major flooding, but ponding on the roads, flooding in areas of, say, low-lying areas, poor drainage zones, those are the spots that could see some water buildup. Also, with the rain moving in along with milder temperatures, some of the ice in some of the rivers to the north and west may experience some minor ice jam flooding as well. Typically a springtime thing, but with warmer air on the way and quite a bit of rain, we have to monitor the rivers as well. In the short term, the concern for mid-evening through the first part of the overnight will be for light icing because temperatures are going to be right near freezing before rising towards early tomorrow morning. So here's a look at your storm timeline. Rainfall, mostly light, will develop during the evening hours, and there will be pockets. Untreated surfaces will glaze over with a light coating of ice. So walkways, driveways, back roads, anything not treated may turn a little bit icy. So give yourself some extra time traveling during the overnight for that. Then during the morning commute tomorrow, all of that light icing goes over to plain old rain. And you can clearly see that rain comes down at a pretty good clip on and off through Friday. It will not be torrential rain all day, but that possibility exists at any one given hour on Friday. Also, a chance of a rumble or two of thunder with an isolated thunderstorm. Gusty winds to boot and climbing temperatures all near record highs by later Friday and early Saturday morning. By the way, Friday evening at 5:23, the winter season officially begins. Certainly on a warm note as well. A couple scattered showers early on Saturday, starting off mild 40s and lower 50s, and then we cool down during the afternoon with rain showers changing over to snow showers across the mountains. In terms of that wind threat, not much of an issue through daybreak on Friday, but notice quickly Friday morning into the early to mid afternoon, winds possibly over 35 to 45 miles per hour could lead to scattered outages, especially in southeastern New Hampshire and in some of the higher terrain of northern parts of the Granite State. Then the wind still a bit active on Saturday, but mainly out of the west northwest at 15 to 30 miles per hour. Again, any spot that gets a wind gust over 35 may see power outages. So that's a concern for Friday into Friday evening. A breezy and mild start to Saturday. The winds pick up even more later on in the day as cooler air builds in, setting the stage for a bright and chilly Sunday. A light dusting to an inch of snow, not out of the question for Christmas Eve day. And then Christmas Day through Wednesday and Thursday, bright and chilly.